The Canadian telehealth industry is just on fire right now, and the two stocks that we're going to talk about today are CloudMD and Well Health Technologies. And for both of these stocks, one's up by 350% year to date, and the other one is up by a whopping 518%. So if you took $10,000 and put it into each of these stocks on January 2nd in 2020, today those investments will be worth $45,000 for Well Health and a whopping $61,800 for your CloudMD investment. But the real question we want to answer in today's video is it too late to buy these stocks? Are these stocks overvalued? Well, cue the intro. So the last intro that I did on the previous videos, it wasn't as well received. So, you know, this is kind of awkward. I'm probably not going to roll that intro. If you guys know anyone who does intros or have any sort of contacts that can help me out, shoot me an email because I would gladly appreciate that. With that, let's just jump right into the video with Mew here, my cat. Anyways, welcome back to the Fire Grind. My name is Daniel, and on this channel, we talk about personal finance and stock market investing. So the format for today's video is I'll be giving you six reasons as to why I believe these stocks just shot up like crazy this year. And at the end of this video, I'll be giving you my thoughts as to if I didn't have a position in either one, would I put money into them today? And if you guys saw my previous update on both these companies, which happened, I think, earlier this week, I have a few new thoughts that came up in this week just doing some more research that I will be sharing with you later on in this video. So stick around. But first off, let's get right into reason number one. So the first reason why I believe these two stocks blew up is because of COVID. So essentially, before COVID happened, people were not as scared to go to doctor's office. In fact, most people would go visit the doctors at their office and not feel like their life was threatened. However, in today's society, people are a lot more cautious, especially with all the masks wearing around. And the last place you want to be as a sick person is at the doctor's office. And the reason for this is if you're at the doctor's office and you're in the waiting room, there's going to be other people in the waiting room, and everyone there who's visiting the doctor has some sort of sickness or has a weak immune system. So those people are high risk. And if you have a bunch of people with weak immune systems and germs, this is just, you know, a bad mix for people getting COVID. So ultimately, I think a lot more people are wary about going to the doctor's office. And this is why telemedicine really blew up. Because when you think about it, you go to your doctor's office and most of the time they're just asking you questions about how you feel, and then they write on a piece of paper what your prescription is and off you go. So really, couldn't you just do that over the phone? And the answer is, for most cases, yes. And not only are doctor's appointments done here, there's other appointments like physio appointments or other specialists like mental health specialists or people who are very specialized in certain type of surgeries. A lot of these professions are just people talking you through, and only on the day of things like surgery will you need to actually go into the office. So because of COVID-19, it has really pushed the telehealth industry forward by 5 to 10 years. And people are a lot more receptive to the idea of seeing their healthcare professionals either through an app or just chatting through messages. And this is very evident in the results that Well Health and CloudMD have both presented in their quarterly earnings. They saw their platform usage go up by triple digits year over year. And same with the American counterparts that they have, like Teladoc and American Well. Now moving on to reason number two. The second reason I have for you guys is their growth numbers. So ultimately, when we're talking about growth numbers, I'm talking about revenue growth here. We can also look at other growth numbers. However, let's keep this short and sweet, and revenue is ultimately the most important thing for businesses. If we take a look at the revenue growth for both Well Health and CloudMD, in the past year, CloudMD has been growing at triple digits. Well Health has been growing a little bit slower at 40% or so. However, in 2019, they saw triple digit revenue growth. This triple digit revenue growth was not just 100%, it was anywhere from 200 to 400% year over year growth. So I think Well Health Technologies, although they have shown slower growth in the past two quarters, I think the growth will accelerate probably in the third and fourth quarter and moving forward. And one thing about Well Health Technologies is that most of the revenue growth came from the medical clinics that they operate. So this is why they didn't see as much revenue growth in 2020 when COVID hit, because a lot of the revenue was tied to the medical clinics. However, when they broke out their software as a service or just their digital platforms, these revenues grew 900% plus year over year. So the third reason I have for you guys here is because of supply and demand. And let me explain this a little bit further. So right now, there's only about four different telehealth companies out there that I know of on the public markets. And these are American Well, which actually IPOed a couple days ago, Teladoc, which acquired Livongo, so that's why I'm not seeing Livongo here, because ultimately those two corporations are going to be merged together. Then we have CloudMD and Well Health. There's also other larger health institutions, but they're not solely focused on telemedicine, whereas these four companies are mainly focused on growing their digital platforms. So because there's only four companies that you and I as retail investors can only invest in, so the supply is low and the demand is quite high because people see the value in telemedicine. So as investors try to find companies to put their money into for telemedicine, which is an industry that's going to grow exponentially in the next 5 to 10 years, they only have four choices. So with supply low and demand high, then the price of these stocks end up going higher. Now moving on to reason number four. The fourth reason as to why these companies really exploded is because of the recent announcement of US expansion. And I think most people probably saw this before they actually announced it because really in Canada, we only have a population of around 36 million people, whereas our neighbors down south have a population of over 300 million people. So roughly 10 times larger of a market. So of course, these two companies, if they really want to expand, they're going to have to go down south as well. Only lately have both these companies announced that they're moving to the States. So even after those announcements, we did see some more stock price appreciation, and this was one of the factors that kept pushing the stocks higher and higher. The fifth reason as to why these stocks moved up even more is because of the mergers and acquisitions, as well as capital raises. So if we look at the M&R activity of both these companies, as well as the capital raises, for CloudMD, we saw that they acquired about 8 different corporations over the past year. So 8 acquisitions in about 9 months is actually quite crazy for a small company like CloudMD. With a market cap of only $250 million, they've been spending a lot of cash to acquire more assets to ultimately grow their market share. And the only way they were able to acquire all 8 of these assets was through capital raises. So CloudMD, they've raised a total of $32 million in this year. So they did one raise of around $18 million in September, as well as a $13 million raise in June, and a $680,000 raise in March. For Well Health, they did 5 acquisitions. So they haven't been acquiring companies as quick as WellMD, as quick as CloudMD. However, 5 acquisitions is still quite a number of acquisitions. And on top of that, Well Health Technologies also did their own capital raises. So they raised a total of $25.4 million over 2 different raises. The first raise was March, where they raised $11 million, and then going forward 2 months later in May, they raised $14.4 million. And one other thing to note about these equity raises, it seems like shareholders really didn't care that they raised money and ultimately diluted shareholders because they kept pushing the stock price up and up. If you look at the stock charts for both these companies, after their raises, the stock eventually kept going up even higher, which means that when the company went to raise again, they had to give away less of the pie for each $1 million that they raised. And if you guys haven't been following Canadian technology stocks out there, a lot of these companies really grew through mergers and acquisitions. And now for the final and sixth reason as to why I believe these stocks jumped so dramatically. And the hint is in the volume. So when we look at the volume of the day-to-day trading, we can see that the volume has been trending upwards, especially in the last 3 months or so. And what this tells me as a retail investor is that no way is this volume from retail investors only. This uptick in volume is ultimately more institutional investors or big boys coming in to buy up the stock. And when these big boys come in, which are like funds or institutions, they're not investing $100 or even thousands of dollars at a time. They're putting in tens of millions to hundreds of millions of dollars into these stocks. And this is, of course, over a period of time. They're not just going to go into the market in one single day and blow 10 grand on CloudMD stock, because that would just shoot the stock price up to insane values. They're going to be buying day over day instead. And reason number 6 is a new piece of information that I discovered in the past couple of days, which has really solidified my position in both of these companies. The fact that institutional investors are putting their money in right now, I think this is the early days for that. So I think going forward from here, we're going to see a lot more institutional investors throw their money into Well Health Technologies as well as CloudMD to be able to diversify their portfolios into health tech stocks. So to answer the question today, if I didn't have a position in either of these companies, would I consider opening up a position at these prices? And the answer is for sure, yes, and hell yeah. I would definitely open up a position in both these companies. I wouldn't throw in all my money right away. However, I'd be looking to average into these companies because they are an exciting opportunity and they are doing nothing but growing their business rapidly. Now let's see if CloudMD or Well Health Technologies is overvalued to determine which one I would choose if I were to buy one of these stocks only. So the way we're going to value these two companies is based on PS ratio, revenue growth year over year percentage wise, as well as their gross margin. So first off, let's look at their American counterparts as a gold standard here. So we can look at American Well first. So their growth of revenue has been 60 to 90% year over year for the past two quarters. We don't have much information beyond that on Finbox, so this is what I'm going to be going by. So the average of that is roughly 75% growth year over year. They have margins in the high 30s and low 40s. However, the trend over time for American Well is that their margins are actually going down. So if you're considering investing in American Well, this is one red flag for me. However, there may be more to the picture, so do your own research and make sure you know why you're buying it. And for their PS ratio, they have a PS ratio of around 25, which I couldn't find online. However, I calculated that based off their market cap and their trailing four quarters of revenue. Now let's turn our attention over to Teladoc. So for the past four quarters, Teladoc's revenue growth has been on average around 44%. However, the trend of the revenue growth has been spiking up, with their latest quarter having a revenue growth year over year of 85%. And Teladoc sports a PS ratio of 23.79. For Well Health Technologies, in 2019, they had some rapid growth where their growth for revenue was around 200 to 400% year over year. And actually there was one quarter, which was the first quarter of 2019, where Finvox reports it to be 5,300% year over year growth. However, in the past two quarters, the growth has come down significantly to around 40% growth year over year. They have gross margins on average of 37%, which is fairly constant over the past four quarters, as well as their PS ratio is 23.3. For CloudMD, their average growth has been 238% year over year in the past four quarters on average. However, their growth from quarter to quarter has also been declining just like Well Health, where it's gone from 349% all the way down to 162% in the latest quarter. But still, a year-over-year growth in revenue of 162% is quite stellar. CloudMD has average margins of 42% in the past four quarters, as well as they have a PS ratio of 24.4. So if we look at all these numbers and just compare CloudMD and Well Health to their American counterparts, we can see that both these stocks are actually not that overvalued. I would say they're fairly valued compared to their American counterparts. So now the question is, which stock would I buy if I can only buy one of them? So the one stock that I would buy out of these two is CloudMD. And the reason why I would buy CloudMD is because they are higher risk, but they have a higher reward potential. Because right now CloudMD's market cap is $250 million, whereas Well Health Technology is nearing $1 billion of market cap. So CloudMD being roughly one-fourth of Well Health Technologies, and their growth is still continuing, I think that CloudMD is going to be able to continue growing quicker than Well Health. And ultimately, what that means for a shareholder is the stock price should appreciate quicker than Well Health. But the case for investing in Well Health Technologies is if you want a less riskier play in the telehealth industry, because Well Health Technologies is generating more revenue, and ultimately with a business with more revenue, this usually means that it's a little bit more stable. The last thing that I want to say about both these companies is that they're still both relatively small companies, and they could both be a target for acquisition. Maybe a large health institution out there would want to come around and acquire either one of these for a good premium. So Well Health Technologies, if it were acquired today, I would expect someone to pay roughly around $2 billion. And for CloudMD, maybe they would pay $750 million for it, because CloudMD is ultimately growing quicker than Well Health Technologies, and as a company coming in to acquire, you're going to have to pay a premium for growth. If you enjoyed this comparison between CloudMD and Well Health Technologies, I'll be doing a lot more videos on these two companies, so please consider subscribing to my channel. You can go right now and just click that button. You know, just down there, I think in this corner right here. Yep, just go click that subscribe button. And if you guys agree or disagree with my decision, as always, let me know in the comments down below. One more thing before we go. If you guys are interested in this IPO, Nuve, which IPOed on the market this past week, however, it was only to institutional investors. Next week, it's opening up to the public. If you want me to do a deeper dive on this company, also let me know in the comments down below. Shoot me an Instagram DM or an email if you want to be more anonymous. I'd be happy to entertain that if there's enough interest. Anyways, keep up the grind and have a great day. Hello, Mew. How's it going? You've been pretty active this whole video. Drop a like for her too as well.